Welcome back to my channel. Today I am participating in the Rediscover Your Stash product focus for August, and that is to use up all our acrylics, whether it's pieces or paint or stamps. And so I'm going to take a little bit of acrylic paint first, and I'm going to mix that with some shimmer spray, which is in London Blue. And I'm just gonna mix that up a little bit with my craft knife. And then I am going to add that to my background. I am going to make a complete mixed media background. And so I wanted to kind of check and see where my photo was gonna be. So I'm gonna use a little pencil there. Then I've got my paintbrush, and I'm just gonna take it through the paint, and I'm just going to go back and forth, trying to keep my lines fairly parallel to each other, making sure that I am getting it on areas that are not going to have pictures or something there. And so I'm just going to go ahead and continue to fill that in just a little bit. I don't want it to be completely filled in. I want to have some little white areas. And so I'm just going to continue to do that. And then I also have some shimmer paint in Razzle Dazzle Berry, and I'm going to sprinkle some of that on there as well. And once I'm finished with that, it's going to dry fairly quickly. So I'm going to use my Distress Oxides, and I am going to create a background with these acrylic stamps. And these are from, let's see, Hampton Arts. And they're ones that you can stamp the image and then stamp the details on top of. And so my first color that I am using is Mustard Seed. And then I'm going to use Ripe Persimmon, Crackling Campfire, and Dusty Concord. And that is going to make up my background. So first I'm stamping the base stamp on there with each of my colors, and I'm trying to kind of work those different colors around my layout, trying not to stamp where I know there's going to be a photo. So I also wanted to stamp a few that go off the edges to just kind of give a little bit of movement. I'm not being super, super careful with how I stamp these because I wanted kind of a messy look to this. So I've got my next ink, and I'm going to finish up with that Dusty Concord, and then I'm going to go back around with the more detailed stamp and some stays on black ink. So now I have all my base stamps, and now I'm going to go back around and create the details on my flowers. And some of them, I want kind of an artsy look to this, so some of them I'm not going to stamp just right on. I'm going to have them kind of overlay a little bit so that it doesn't look just perfect. That is kind of my goal here. I want to have the outline on there, but I'm not really being super, super careful as to whether or not it's directly above. So there is what I ended up with. And I'm only using one photo today, and this is of my husband and I in Disneyland meeting Mirabel, which was super exciting to me. I actually had my Bruno shirt on that day. Of course, we did not talk about it, but we did take pictures, and I got her autograph, which I am going to mount on some black cardstock as well, because I did have it in a notebook and the paper is rather thin, so I did want to just reinforce that with that little black border around it. So that is going to be the only picture and autograph that I'm going to put on here. And I'm really going to let my stamping and my mixed media be the star of this page. I don't know if you've ever had character autographs. It appears that if you have a larger piece of paper, they will in fact sign it as large as your paper. So I have found that for scrapbooking purposes, if I want to use those autographs, I need to get smaller notebooks. That way I have smaller autographs. But that was okay. I really loved how she put the little butterfly and the flower on top as well. So I did add an acrylic piece, and that is from Scraps and Ink Craft. It just says Mirabel. There are several of them in this package, but I just wanted to use that one acrylic stamp. And now I have some sequins from Spiegel Mom Scraps, and this is the Golden Glow sequin pack, and I am going to add those to the top and to the bottom of my layout. I'm just going to place those by hand because I am that person that does that. It takes me just a few minutes, but I really like being able to have a little bit more control over what I do with it. And as you'll see, I also have some little butterflies around, and this is from Bella Boulevard. There's some puffy stickers. I'm going to add some little puffy hearts as well. And then I'm going to finish up with a little bit of shimmer paint again, and just putting that around. Now you'll see the blue I'm going to kind of mess up, and so I'm going to fix that by just drawing a few little lines in my background, and I think it's going to work out just fine. So you can look at that at the end of the video in my final close-ups. Also, as you're looking through my close-ups, I always put a hidden Mickey on my Disney pages, and so you will see in the sequins I have also created a hidden Mickey, and that's one of my favorite things to do with sequins when I'm doing a Disney page. So now I just want to finish up those little hearts. I've got my butterflies, I've got my flowers, and I am going to try to call it done. I wanted to add more, but I just decided, you know what, I think this is officially done, and I'm just going to call it the way it is once I have gone back and forth with that. So again, thanks so much for stopping by my channel. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're not yet a subscriber, of course, hit that subscribe button as well. There are several people who are playing along both on Instagram and YouTube. And so I will link in the description area their videos as well. I hope you all have a magical day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye, everyone.